понятно. What does it mean nationally, I would like to say, in anticipation of Affordable Care Act? Nationally, it means reducing the healthcare cost as it has been stated in the JAMA of 2012 in October by two leading U.S. health policymakers, Arnold Milstein and Stephen Shortell, that this methodology, if applied to all the hospitals in the United States, has a potential of reducing overall healthcare cost by 4 to 5%, which is over $100 billion a year. That's practically quite comparable with the amount of money that we want to remove from Medicare. And maybe that should be the rather starting point, eliminating this avoidable waste, and then talk about the Medicare survivability. US hospitals are being occupied. The bed occupancy in the US hospitals are between 65% and 67%. We are one third idle. We are one third empty and overcrowded. Why? Because we remember only those peaks when we have a peak in patient demand due to the elective admission. All other industrialized countries, with no exception, have a much higher average census. Canada, for example, has an average census of 90%. Canada has the same problem with variability in patient flow, but for them it's much more difficult to manage it than for us. Again, we are one third idle and overcrowded. What should be the limit for the bed occupancy? The bed occupancy in the United States, depending on the type of the hospital, could be between 80% and 90%+. Today we have, roughly speaking, 65. So the difference that we have today between the current average bed occupancy and the bed occupancy we could have is between 15% and 25%+. What does that mean? The number of uninsured, proportion rather, of uninsured in the country is about 15%. It means that if we assume that uninsured population is distributed proportionally to other insured population, it means that we have a bed for everybody. And what does that mean? The capital cost of a new bed in the United States is between $1 and $2 million, with operational cost over quarter million a year. So clearly, that's a huge amount of money, and we don't need to spend it. We can do it with our current resources for the all uninsured population. If, however, we will not do that, we're imposing significant stress on the hospital that's already dysfunctional. So if we do not smooth the, if we do not address patient flow at the hospital, if you do not manage it properly, it reminds me a very strange discussion that frequently I hear from the politician, whether we can or cannot get uninsured to the current healthcare system. That reminds me the discussion between the husband and wife, whether they should, he should take his mother-in-law for a ride if the car is not moving because the engine is broken. So it's not a matter of taking mother-in-law for a ride. It's a matter of fixing the engine. The U.S. healthcare car is broken. So it has been, it has to be fixed. And it could be fixed free of charge. And once it's fixed, yes, it could accommodate the demand of uninsured.